So, plantar fasciitis is one of the most common disorders of the foot. It is also known as plantar heel pain. So, plantar fasciitis is caused by the inflammation of the plantar fascia. So, this ligament is structured on the sole of the foot. The thick band of the tissue on the bottom of the foot. Plantar fasciitis is usually diagnosed by the clinical examination. The most common symptom is pain in the heel or sole of the foot. The pain is usually worse when walking, standing for a period of time, or after intense physical activity. Possible risk factors may include obesity. Although heel spurs are frequently seen on the x-rays in case of the plantar fasciitis, patients some debate as to whether there is a correlation between heel spurs and this disorder, so it's not clear. The majority of the incidents occur in the group of people between age 40 and 60. Plantar heel pain may be the result of the other underlying disorders, yes, like the arthropathy or heelpathy, rupture of the plantar fascia, or even sarcoidosis. Sarcoidosis is quite rare disease of unknown etiology. Running on the hard surface, repeatedly jumping up and down, or suddenly undertaking intense workouts are examples of some activities that can cause stress fractures. Yes, so the stress fractures are when we are generally rapidly increasing the rate of loading of our limbs. For example, when the sedentary patient tries to run a lot, yes, run hard. It may, especially when this patient is, for example, 40 years old, yes, it may lead to some stress fractures. Stress fractures are classified as being at high risk or low risk of complications depending on the location of the injury. They are usually diagnosed through the physical examination. Early diagnosis is imperative to help avoid further complications. Risk factors include low bone density. Generally, women are at higher risk of stress fractures than men. Yes, and the toe fractures are fairly common and account for nearly 9% of fractures treated by primary care physicians. Yes, so they are maybe not so problematic, but for sure not nice. And there is significant association between plantar fasciitis diagnosis and time spent on the feet. Overall research showed that increased risk of foot and ankle disorder associated with more time spent walking. Whereby every 10% of the day spent walking resulted in 20% if the musculoskeletal disorder risk. Higher metatarsal pressure was also associated with foot and ankle disorders. Yes, so higher metatarsal pressure is when we have the higher body mass. Yes, simply speaking. These results suggest that when it comes to foot and ankle disorder, there's a complex interplay between a lot of different factors.